Hello and good morning guys, and in this video I am going to discuss the distribution of marks and categorization of all the chapters of cost and management audit. The idea behind this video is to make you revise your cost and management audit subject in a very very limited manner. In a short span of time you can do focus study, because you would have only one day or half a day before your examination. So this will help you in revising your key important chapters of cost and management audit. So as you can see on your screen, I have divided all the chapters of cost and management audit into three categories: category A, category B, category C. This categorization has been made on the basis of the scores which has been for which the questions have been coming from all of these chapters. If you see, then category A comprises of two chapters. One is records 2014 and second is the management reporting issues. Guys, I have clubbed the case studies on management reporting or performance analysis also in chapter number 2. So if you see, these two chapters alone are having a weightage of approximately 60 plus marks. Now please don't get bedazzled with the marks which are written in the table, because this 76 64 is from 120 marks, from which the paper actually comes for 120 marks because of the optional questions. So if I only focus on the compulsory marks, then these two chapters can fetch you 60 plus marks. Wow, not a bad deal guys. Just with two chapters you can easily clear of your examination. Now coming on to category B, guys, category B would entail cost accounting standards, and I've already told you cost accounting standards 1 to 10 and 22 to 20 and 24 are the most important cost accounting standards, and you can easily go through them and you can read other ones casually. So this is the objective which we are going to follow for cost accounting standards. And you need not study GACAP, because a question from GACAP has never been asked in the examination. Next two chapters are from theory, guys: management audit in different functions and internal control, internal audit, etc. So these two chapters are also there in category B. So if I now club category A and category B, guys, approximately 80 plus marks are fetched by only five chapters which are there in category A and category B. So you need not touch category C at all before your examination. Just revise these five chapters and you'll be done for cost and management audit. Now, having said that, let me tell you two chapters of category C which I would recommend you to definitely go through once. Just read, give 15 minutes for these two chapters. The two chapters are professional ethics and audit documentation. Guys, about audit documentation, let me tell you that audit documentation is a new chapter which has been introduced in January 2019 itself. Therefore, it's pivotal to do this chapter, because it will definitely have a question of 4 to 5 marks in the examination. Therefore, I'm asking you to just read audit documentation and professional ethics, and you can leave other chapters of category C and you will be done for your cost and management audit revision. This will help you in revising your cost and management audit in merely half a day or just in within few hours. So guys, all the very best. Last few days to go. I can wish you all the luck in the examination. Please trust in your studies, trust in God, and have faith in blessings of your parents. All the very best and happy studying.